Okay, yeah, let me know when you're ready and then I'll...
We're ready when you are.
Well, my family moved to Sacramento in 1965, and so that's the year Bob Dylan came out with Just Like a Rolling Stone. So I got a guitar, and I wanted to learn how to play guitar just like Bob Dylan, sit under a tree and play Just Like a Rolling Stone, just like Bob Dylan. Well, actually, back in 1982, I had a buddy that had a window cleaning business, so he used to take me around town, you know, like between Midtown and Rancho Cordova, cleaning windows. And so in 1983, when I first moved downtown, I was looking for work, and I couldn't find any work, but I found a squeegee, so I just, you know, got some equipment together with a bucket and, you know, started cleaning windows. Then I did have other jobs on the side, But since 1989, I've been going mainly just cleaning windows. The old Sacramento Stucco Factory, that was over at 27th and R Street. And the history behind that is that they used to make stucco there, but then the company moved to West Sacramento. Anyway, this guy Brian Gorman leased it, and then he rented spaces out to individual artists because it was made out of sheet metal and it had a lot of rooms, you know, for storage and so on. And at one end, there was like a stage they used for like a stage. The other end had a basement, so they turned that into like a recording studio.
Come along with me to Gary's studio. There's Gary over there.
And so they had a lot of different artists that had their art spaces there. Then they used to have art openings, and then plus, you know, pop bands. And eventually they had, you know, 16 or 20 different bands used to practice and make recordings down in the recording studio in the basement. So they used to have hundreds of punk rockers were hanging out. That was kind of like the peak of the punk rocker scene was back there in the late 80s. And my buddy Brave Dave, he was the video man. He was taking a lot of videos, and then we had other productions going on. There was the Nebula Stucco thing with Steve Vanoni, who's one of the famous artists. He's a famous artist around town. Then they had the downtown poets. They'd read their poetry, and then they were backed up with the avant-garde music. And then I used to open for them. I used to play some Bob Dylan songs with guitar and harmonica. So it was pretty cultural, you know, fun, exciting thing going on with the poets and artists and musicians all kind of putting on productions together. They had a big courtyard. I used to practice, you know, guitar and harmonica there. It was sort of a... you know, kind of a come and go place because, you know, there was other venues. There was the I Dream Ice Cream Parlor that was going on at the same time. So there was like a whole bunch of punk rockers hanging out there. And I had my skateboard and I'd be cleaning windows around town. Then when I got off work, I'd go over to I Dream Ice Cream Parlor and play my guitar. We'd hang out and play guitars there. And then once in a while, there was something going on at the old Stucco Factory, but it wasn't... you know, it wasn't all the time, you know. It was just once in a while they had parties. It wasn't a full-time thing going on because see, one of the things with the artists is they need their peace and quiet to concentrate on their artwork. So a lot of times there was nothing going on there. You know, they just said, yeah, we need peace and quiet and, you know, we'll, you know, no more parties for a while. We just got to get to work around here, you know. Because that's how they made their money, is selling their art, and they had to work on their artwork. So there was that part of it too. So it wasn't all a big party all the time. There was a lot of work involved. And I was cleaning windows, getting my business going, and then playing guitar at places. And so it was pretty much the whole era was the Stucco Factory was part of it. So there's a lot of people that I still see from back then that I've known for years. And in fact, you know, most of them, they're still into their artwork. You know, my buddy Gary Denon, he's still doing artwork. Actually, Steve Vanoni, he's got the Horse Cow Gallery. He still does way avant-garde art. You know, I think it went through some transitions. There was, I believe Brian Gorman leased the whole building. I think it was around 1983 or 84, because that's when I first started going there. And then it burnt down, I think, in 92. And so it just burnt down, and so everybody was kind of sad about it because, you know, it was just, that was a real cultural place, that everybody loved that place. It was just a fun place, you know, for making videos and just a lot of fond memories, you know, of just, a lot of friends hanging out there and art openings and doing a lot of cultural activities. So I think it was a great place, but, you know, it's kind of sad to see it go. And I think it's something positive. I think that's what makes people creative. If there's something positive, like artwork or music, if they're doing something creative, it kind of keeps the energy positive. And I think that's important.
How does it feel? Now tell me, how does it feel? Be out there on your own. With no direction home. Just like a complete unknown. Just like a rolling stone.
Cool.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right.